needed the sister Blue read this shit, and this is a phenomenon. This is a phenomenon that happened to me when the goddess Tara was coming through. You'll sit there and tears will start rolling down your eyes. You feel no emotion, but you cannot stop your eyes from crying. And basically, it's the cleaning out, and Tara is tears. Now, when she read this thing, she said she read it 3 times in a row, each time these tears. So immediately, I knew she was going to another level spiritually. This stuff is supposed to shed off forms of your humanity. So this was a powerful writing. We were supposed to do it earlier. It only happened within a week after we did the show with Bobby and myself together.
Yeah.
Now, since then, Farrakhan did a whole thing acknowledging Michael Jackson as the Archangel Michael.
Right, he did.
He did a whole thing on it. So this thing is a reality. It's a phenomenon. There's some proof for your ass. We're the first ones to say it, bring it out from the ethers, and then you have other entities speaking on it. I'm even told Phil Valentine acknowledged it on either a radio show or somewhere as well, as Michael being the Archangel Michael.
Mm-hmm.
At least I was told that. So other people are acknowledging this thing after we channeled it. There's some proof for that ass. So maybe 3 to 4 days later, we started picking up shit from Mike. Now, what we found out was, with all the people playing his old Michael Jackson shit from, you know, from the 60s and 70s, he couldn't find that light. He was looking for a light. And when we did the radio show, he came through the next day and said he heard everything. I got that. Bobby told me that separately. Yeah, Mike came to me and said he heard everything. I said, yeah, the nigga said the same shit to me. We were the light that he was looking for. We were that light that he was looking for, this conscious light. And even us getting together and the acclimates for the show, you bringing the show, it was all a part. It wasn't just me and Bobby. It was the coming together, and it was a eulogy to send Mike off correctly. This conscious light coming together, and what we were saying were lining up with what people were feeling about Mike. This was enough to show Mike where to go. So the first thing that started happening after Mike came through the next day, said he heard the show, Linda, Bobby's queen, started picking up shit from Mike. And all he would do was question, asking who Hilton Hotema is, asking all this conscious shit, getting up to speed. They said they had to leave books open for him so he could read all day. He's asking about shit in Bobby's house, asking for water, asked for popcorn, asked him for like a cheeseburger, hamburgers and fries and all that kind of shit. Basically, when they do that, this spirit, that symbolical physical thing we're doing of feeding them transforms into spiritually feeding them. You get what I'm saying? So spiritually, he was feeding them, energizing Mike. So I said, okay, this nigga's going to show up. He damn sure showed up. Me in the dream state, this nigga kept me up the entire night. What he asked me about, I have a deity called Lama Dama. Lama Dama is basically the great mother figure. But Lama Dama is dressed like the classic Aunt Jemima. So most people as a human have been taught to hate this figure. But if anybody knows about transformation, that Queen Mother Yemenya, great mother figure, must transform. So she turned into, at one point, Aunt Jemima, that big fat mama. And so that avatar still is valid, if you will, for the great mother. That's a part of her transformation, because that's her transformation in America. Not many people will get with that. So she's on my altar with Kuan Yin, Isis, Kali, you know, with all the rest of the goddesses, you know, Lakshmi and the rest of them. He couldn't figure out why this Aunt Jemima was up there when we were taught that's an image we were trying to socially get away from. He asked me all about it. I told him all about transformation. The shit took all night. And I was like, look, nigga, you cannot do that to me. I need to sleep. Next night he came through, and he actually asked me what was liquor all about. Why are we giving up liquor? So I explained to him, you know, the water, you know, most of the ancestors want the water. It's symbolic of, you know, the thirst quenching and blah, 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 the life, blah, blah, blah. The liquor's like gasoline when you want to get shit done. So, you know, I was like, that's like doing a show at, water's like doing a show at PS or Junior High School 192. That them concerts you've been doing in them stadiums, that's what the liquor's like feeding you, the energy for that. So you got that. So So I'm like, I'm still thinking it's going to take him a while to come through because he needs to sift through all of that, you know, radio shows and VH1 specials, because all of those things act like anchors that ground you in the physical world. So while you think that you're helping Mike, you're technically supposed to be pushing them away, but you actually pull them down with that, Mike, we miss you, and all that kind of shit. He's a nigga, if any other nigga, that doesn't need fan acclimates. You know, grown white man pass out in stadiums over here. So he doesn't need acclimates. What he needed was understanding. Why was I such the phenomenon from day one? When Bobby and myself on your show was given this conscious information to define his mythology, St. Michael and so on and so forth, when we were defining his mythology, it was a definition that he needed to remember himself and why he came to Earth and blah, 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 and his destiny and what he needed to do. So I said, well, let me see what's up. I'm a go downtown, do what I need to do, and I'm going to stop to get the hamburger and french fries that Mike wanted, turkey burgers. As I'm walking, and Rich, you from New York, and you know what time it is on West 4th with them bums selling them books. Outside is like Skid Row walking through that motherfucker.
Yeah.
Within the drudgery of this Sanford and Son landscape, there was this motherfucking picture. The shit called to me. It was Mike, it was hand-drawn, it was Mike in that top hat, same picture from Ebony, drawn with these Field of Reeds, called me and said, rescue me. I said, shit. I started to walk. I said, nope, I got to get this shit. Went, motherfuckers were stopping, pointing to this picture within the landscape of all this bum shit. I picked it up, waited for this bum for about 10 to 15 minutes. He came. He said, $2. He looked at my face. $5. I said, nigga, you just said $2. I'll give you $3. I'll give you $3, you bum ass. You know what I'm saying? You know, so then I said, okay. Then I said, no, Mike wanted that $5 for it, that donation. I said, no, son, bro, here, take $5. Took it. Immediately, Mike started coming through, running his mouth. Yeah, nigga, this is a gateway. I'm going to come through this. I'm going to do this. I'm going to do that for you. He said, give it to Bobby Hemmett. I said, oh, fuck. What? I like, said, give it to Bobby Hemmett. And he's going to try to put it near the Baron Samedi altar. Tell him to put it near the Pan altar. Now I'm pissed. I'm like, I got to give this fucking picture to this nigga. I'm like, fuck. So took it home, put it up, you know, put it to the side, you know, told Bobby, yeah, this, that, yeah, nigga, I don't really want to put it to the side. Sure enough, Michael's ass comes through hard than a motherfucker. And I'm going to go through the channel because I have to go through reading it because I don't really remember it. I'll go with what I remember and see if I leave anything out. Now, let me say this now. I wrote this up. It reads better, even with the typos, it reads better than I can ever explain it because it was meant to be written up in the first place. Even though people are like, no, you need to do an audio on it. I was like, well, Rich already put his stake in the ground for that. You know what I mean? So yeah. I said, I got to do that for Rich. But you can read what I wrote on this particular channel on my MySpace page. Just go to myspace.com/pandemon, PANDEMON. And just go to my blogs, and there it is. So I'm going to explain what it is he was telling me and how I decoded it. First thing, and this is not a big deal for me, I've helped many people can testify to this. I've helped people go through these dimensions. When we sleep, there are many dimensions, many subdimensions. We also call these dimensions sifferas at these points. And they'll tell you each sifera is a malkuth, which means there are subdimensions. That's a matrix. So this matrix, most people get caught in when they die based upon whatever it is they were dealing with. For instance, Sister Nicole was telling me that her father has all these spirits around his house, and there's one nigga that chops wood all the time. So I explained to her that's not hot. When he died, see, what probably happened in life, he was able to feed his kids, able to keep the slave bastards whipped his ass, probably able to tell his kids, you know, you're the first one to go to college based upon me doing this job of chopping wood. So chopping wood to him may have been all his self-esteem that brought dignity to his home, to his family, and whatever. So when he died, this nigga stuck in a loop because he knows nothing else of chopping wood. That gives him happiness and satisfaction.
Right.
The that needs to be free. So these dimensions are the death of you. That's nothing but those paths and those cipheras. And I spiritually visited those cipheras, not even just, you know, logically talking about them. I went to those in the spirit world, and it's fucked up. Even the best one, Chassad, the Mercy, or whatever the fuck, whichever that is, I went there, and it was a cookout. It was a nigga cookout. And there was no knife fights or nothing. But I was like, yo, y'all niggas ain't thinking about going above. I was pointing above. Above the abyss. Niggas tell me, no, you got to be right to go up there. I was like, yeah, nigga, let's go. And even though this was a wonderful, calm place and there was a chicken in every pot, niggas was still dumb and fucked up. On the other side, I also went to see Mars, none but a bunch of disgruntled niggas. And, you know, so Matrix, that's why they say the middle path, straight path to God. You're supposed to go up that middle path to Kepa and all that kind of shit. So these dimensions are fucked up. So what I had to do was navigate Mike so he doesn't get trapped in the dimension. And that would be hard for Mike because all this love he's getting, he could be trapped in the dimension when he's doing a show every night and just getting those accolades. He knew better than that. I navigated him through, and what I seemed to get him to was a point where there was an abyss-type thing, and there was a beast beyond it. The only place I heard this before is Jarl the Boss swimming below the abyss, which is nothing but the humanity or the human ego. Now, it was little Michael Jackson. As I moved over the abyss, Mike got caught, and he's wrestling with Jarl the Boss. In other words, he's wrestling with a new incarnation. There were people around this area as if they were waiting there for 1,000 years for some mythology to happen, for something to return. So I realized that this young Mike was the one to return. So they kept saying to me, give it to him. I was like, what the fuck are they talking about? They kept saying, give it to him. So I gave him some light, and it turned into a sword. Now, this nigga turned into anybody who does candle magic, the Orisha shit, the saints, Saint Michael. There's Saint Michael, and he's in the classic move where he stands above the devil with his sword pointed down. Mike turned into a man and was in all white. In this image, even in the dream, a lucid dream, and basically, if you didn't pick up on anything I said before, a lucid dream is basically you retaining your consciousness in the dream. So in other words, the same competence that I have here with my intellect and my know-how, I still bring that in the dream world and can use that in my balance in the dream world. I still have that ammunition. So I'm sitting there going, I've seen this pose before. I said, shit, that's the Saint Michael. Now, I said, he turned into St. Michael. All the shit we talked about on the radio, he heard his mythology and stepped right in it. St. Michael is also Dael, Michael, the angel, Archangel Michael, St. Michael are interchangeable. We even said that night. Interchangeable. Right. Golden white light, white beyond the standard white that we see, and his sword was his power. The next thing I've seen, The people started rejoicing. He came up multicolored out of these steps. There's also a multicolored St. Michael candle as well. And I said, yo, because I felt responsible for him after guiding him out of these dimensions. I felt responsible for him. So I asked him, is there anything you need? He said, I need for you to get out the way. And this nigga burnt up an entire, I guess, planet, world, dimension, Sephira, a tree, however you want to name this reality within, this nigga tore this shit down. So in the spirit world, who gets these things first, he opened up a gateway, and a lot of these wood-chopping niggas stuck just got free based upon Mike. Now, we the last ones to get these things, so when the earth ends, that's when it all comes to a head. But when it happens up there, it trickles its way down here, and people start to feel it in different ways based upon it being interpreted by this reality. Now, I was getting also a lot of mail from a lot of conscious people with a different story of Michael transcending. So what that means is all these people who do deal with consciousness and do get some form of intuition and some form of channel got confirmation the way they interpreted it as Michael actually making it out, not getting stuck in the dimension. Now, if somebody just asks, is Earth ending to me? If you ain't figured that shit out, the Christians will tell you that Earth is ending. If you ain't figured out Earth is ending, then you need to go back to the drawing board. You know what I mean? yes, this motherfucker's ending. You ain't figured that shit out. Women are throwing babies in dumpsters and going back to their